Good morning, everyone. I would like to welcome our Honorable Principal Ma'am, Sandeep Ma'am, esteemed judges and parents, faculty members and students on this beautiful morning. What you all will be witnessing in the next 60 minutes is an outcome of a great teamwork that has been displayed by the students of Class 11C. I would like to thank Principal Ma'am for giving us this opportunity to be a part of this talent festival, The Spectrum. Now I'm going to leave the stage for our young hosts, Nishchay, Archisha and Akshara. Now the stage is yours.
All the best.
जो मुस्कुरा रहा है उसे गम ने पाला होगा, जो मुस्कुरा रहा है उसे गम ने पाला होगा, जो चल रहा है उसके पांव में छाला होगा, बिना संघर्ष के इंसान चमक नहीं सकता, जो जलेगा उसके दिए में तो उजाला होगा, जो जलेगा उसी दिए में तो उजाला होगा।
A very refreshing morning to the revered principal ma'am, esteemed judges, respected teachers and my fellow companions. Today we, the students of class 11C, present before you India, soaring high on the wings of fame, power and success.
India, land of our dreams, our motherland. How much we love her who has nurtured and nourished us. India is emerging as a great superpower, making the world sit up and notice the great success story of India.
With over 1.3 million men and women in uniform and over 1 million in reserve, the Indian Armed Forces is the largest volunteer warfighting force in the world. Indian Air Force has more than 665 combat-capable aircrafts in its inventory and is actively engaged in the acquisition of several fourth and fifth generation fighters. India's Navy, often touted as a sign of India's military influence overseas, has more than 40 submarines and ships on order.
Now, without any further ado, we would like to start our event by drawing your attention towards a wonderful collage presented by our collage team about India emerging as a military superpower.
Indian Army is one of the most outstanding armies in the world. Ensuring national security and national unity is the main focus of Indian Army. Our army is fighting against external aggression and internal threats and maintain peace and security within Indian borders. The Indian Army is also upgrading and acquiring new assets for its armed, artillery and aviation branches. One of the major steps taken by it is to introduce Rafale in Indian Air Force. The Rafale is a twin jet fighter aircraft able to operate from both an aircraft carrier and an shore base. The fully versatile Rafale is able to carry out all combat aviation missions, all superiority and air defense, close air support, in-depth strikes, anti-ship strikes and nuclear deterrence. The Rafale entered service with the French Navy in 2004 and with the French Air Force in 2006 with more than 30,000 flight hours in operations. Price of estimate at 58,000 crore by the Defense Ministry of India from France Dassault Aviation. The origin of the deal lies in the Indian MRCA competition, a multi-billion dollar contract to supply 126 multi-role combat aircraft to the Indian Air Force. Rafale is a French twin-engine Canard Delta Wing multi-role fighter aircraft designed and built by Dassault Aviation. Equipped with a wide range of weapons, the Rafale is intended to perform air supremacy, interdictions, ground support, in-depth strike, anti-ship strike and nuclear deterrence missions. The Rafale is referred to as an omni-role aircraft by Dassault. Many of the aircraft's avionics and features, such as direct voice input, the RBE-22AA active electronically scanned array radar, and the optronic sector frontal infrared search and track sensor, were domestically developed and produced for the Rafale program. The aircraft is available in three main variants: Rafale C, single-seat land-based version; Rafale B, twin-seat land-based version; and Rafale M, single-seat carrier-based version. The Rafale is a twin-engine fighter aircraft that is capable of carrying out multiple kind of mission. Each engine provides a thrust of 75 kN. It has a long-range air-to-air missile, contains laser-guided bombs, has AM-39 Exocet anti-ship missile, has highly agile and maneuverable extended range, contains store management system of 1760 complacent. They are equipped with buddy-buddy refueling that allows one aircraft to lend its fuel to another while still in flight. It can fire Meteor missiles to take off targets that are out of visual range. Scalp missile can take out on ground targets 300 km away. They carry 6 AASM missile at a time. It has holographic cockpit display. Rafale can aim for 8 targets at a time. The Rafale fighter jet ordered by India are being customized for the Indian Air Force. They will have the ability to land and take off quickly from high altitude areas like the air base in Leh. Indian Air Force Rafale will also receive radar warnings to identify hostile tracking system, as well as a towered decoy system to throw off any incoming missile attack. After covering a distance of 7,000 km from France, first batch of 5 Rafale fighter jets landed in India for the first time. The fighter jets landed at Ambala Air Base. This aircraft has the power to carry out nuclear weapons and is the only fighter aircraft in the world that has the power to destroy the enemy even from the height of 55,000 feet. Significantly, its induction in the Indian Air Force is expected to give an upper hand to India, since neither Pakistan nor China have similar capability aircraft with them. Coming from a family of servicemen, Group Captain Harkirat Singh was back in 2009 honored with the Shaurya Chakra. Group Captain Harkirat Singh scripted history as the first commanding officer of the 17th Squadron of the Rafale fighter jet when the first batch of the French machine lands in Ambala. Wing Commander Abhishek Tripathi was among the air's crew flying the French fighter jet to India. He belongs to a small town, Barauni, in UP. The crew included Wing Commander Manish Singh. He is a son of an ex-army man, Madan Singh, whose joy had no bounds as the fighter landed in Ambala base. He belongs to Bakhwan village in Balia district of UP. The crew also includes Group Captain Rohit Kataria, who brought the fighter plane from France. After the landing, he was promoted from Wing Commander to Group Captain in Indian Air Force. He belongs to Gurugram, Haryana. Among the 5 Rafale pilots was Wing Commander Arun Kumar, who hails from Bihar. His father was a junior warrant officer in the military. All of these 5 pilots went to France for a special training for a duration of 6 months on September 2019. But due to COVID-19 pandemic, their stay was prolonged. Flight Lieutenant Shivangi Singh is set to become the first woman fighter pilot of India to fly the Rafale combat aircraft. She hails from UP's Varanasi and was commissioned into the Indian Air Force in the year 2017 as the part of second batch of women fighter pilots. Induction ceremony of Rafale fighter jets into Indian Air Force was held at Ambala Air Base on 10 September. A formal induction ceremony of the 5 high-profile Rafale fighter aircrafts into the Indian Air Force Golden Arrow Squadron was held at Ambala Air Base. French Defense Minister Florence Parly was there in the induction ceremony with Union Defense Minister Mr. Rajnath Singh. In spite of the fear of further spread of COVID-19 pandemic, large number of people came out of their houses to celebrate the homecoming of newly acquired defense source. The joy of the people had no bounds when the Rafale entered Indian Air Force. After Rafale, here comes the great protection system made by India for the soldiers, the Bhabha Kavach.
Bhabha Kavach is India's first lightest and the indigenous bulletproof jacket. It is developed by the Ordnance Factory Board and the Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited. Carbon nanomaterial technology is taken from the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, hence it is named as Bhabha Kavach. It is built from layers of polyethylene which has high density and tenacity. These layers are fused together at high temperatures to form a thick, hard armored plate which is then sprayed with BARC's carbon nanomaterial. Each Bhabha Kavach has four hard armor plates which protect the wearer from front, back and both the sides. It provides 360 degree protection. It has a protection level of National Institute of Justice. Central Armed Police Forces is the main user of this jacket. Bhabha Kavach has given a boost to Make in India program. Export orders for the jacket are expected from South American, African and East Asian countries. The material used in the jacket are hard boron carbide ceramics, carbon nanotubes and composite polymer. The Kavach weighs 9.2 kg, a half kilogram less than the weight for a bulletproof jacket prescribed by the Union Ministry of Home Affairs. It quoted a senior Ordnance Factories Board official as saying the jacket is powered with nanotechnology from Bhabha Atomic Research Center and has a 5-year warranty. Bhabha Kavach, billed as India's lightest bulletproof jacket, was launched at the International Police Expo 2019 in New Delhi last week. The bulletproof jacket, developed jointly by the Ordnance Factories Board and the public sector metals and metal alloys manufacturer Mithani, can withstand bullets from an AK-47 assault rifle and the 5.56mm INSAS rifle.
These additions has not only made us proud, but also confident enough to face any kind of threat looming large in our neighborhood in the present times. Induction of Rafale and Bhabha jacket has strengthened and empowered us to look at our enemy in the eye. It can be counted as one step ahead in beefing up our security.
Thank you.
Wow, what a spectacular depiction. India indeed is succeeding in leaps and bounds.
Yes, indeed. It was a wonderful collage presented by our collage team. Our India is indeed becoming a powerful nation.
Sahil pe pahunchne se inkar kise hai, lekin Sahil pe pahunchne se inkar kise hai, lekin tufano se ladne ka maza hi kuch aur hai. Kehte hain कि किस्मत खुदा लिखता है लेकिन कहते हैं कि किस्मत खुदा लिखता है लेकिन उसे मिटा के खुद गढ़ने का मजा ही कुछ और है उसे मिटा के खुद गढ़ने का मजा ही कुछ और है इसरो इज द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट एंड लीडिंग इंडियन स्पेस एजेंसी ऑन अर्थ इट्स विजन इज टू हार्नेस स्पेस टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर नेशनल डेवलपमेंट व्हाइल पर्स्यूइंग स्पेस साइंस रिसर्च and planetary exploration. Now, I would like to invite Archisha to take over and tell us something about our presentation.
When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, life is queer with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when they might have won, had they stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow, you may succeed with another blow. Through the presentation of Class 11C, we are going to show the glimpses of the challenges faced by ISRO and the feasible solutions found by them. So dear audience, here it is, Chandrayaan 3, a success story to be. Giving us the message that if we strive hard unitedly, success is surely ours. The world has its eyes on the mission, which, if successful, will make India only the fourth nation after United States, China, and Russia to make a soft landing on the lunar surface.
Liftoff will start in T-minus 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have ignition.
Enable emergency protocol. The orbiter has spiraled out of control. We are unable to regain access of Vikram.
Establishing urgent contact. We can't contact Vikram. I repeat, we have lost communication with Vikram.
Try again for 3 times. Run a complete scan, report the objectives, and compile an analysis right now.
Oh no! This can't be happening. We just entered the fourth stage of landing. We can't fail now.
Analysis is complete, but Vikram is still not responding. We are yet to find the cause.
Connection isn't being established. It's over. We should accept this and prepare to address a press conference right now.
But it can't be so. We worked so hard on this project. We can't give up now.
Yes, we work day and night. This doesn't make any sense. We can't fail like this.
That is true, everybody. We put in hard work. That is what we should always do. But still, we can never determine the consequences of our action. We shouldn't let this setback define. We regret to inform that communication with Vikram rover was lost this morning at 10:31 IST. Indian Space Research Organization designed Chandrayaan 2 to soft land a probe on the moon, but the mission has failed. This is a setback for us, and we are continuously working to overcome and identify the cause and rectify it.
What was the reason for the failure of this mission? Wasn't the lander supposed to make a soft landing?
We are yet to find the exact reason pertaining for the same. The lander as well as the software functioned properly during the crash.
Is there a chance to recover the lost contact with Vikram? Has the debris pertaining to the crash been found so that we can be certain about the fate of the lander?
Our team is continuously working in hopes to revive the lander, but we have very less time. As soon 14 Earth nights will start in the South Pole, which will witness freezing temperature, and the chance to energize the lander with solar energy will be
the news of Chandrayaan is spreading like wildfire. Many people have many stances. Some people
scattered across news channels and all over the internet. Our dignity is tattered. What will we do now?
My fellow team members, never stop believing in yourself. Don't forget that people are still looking up to us. We must find out what went wrong and make room for improvement.
Absolutely right. We can't stop now. We shouldn't make our hard work go to waste. But for that, we should start diagnosing where we went wrong.
Yes, this is true.
We will try our best.
Come on, let's make our country proud.
I think I found it. We may finally have the answer.
That's great. Go on.
According to the diagnosis, we ran the analysis report. It became quite clear that we lost the contacts not because of the machinery fault but due to a last minute software glitch which led to the
Then the Vikram lander must have crash landed on the surface of the moon after its guidance is kaput.
And therefore, the Vikram lander must have lost control 50 meters short of the lunar surface and crashed.
But how could this be as the software was functioning well throughout the trial period?
I think the lander must have experienced trouble during its spine breaking, so it's veered off its trajectory.
I think we can fix this.
But how does it matter? We have already failed our mission and used all our funds.
We'll never know if we never try. I must inform our seniors about this development and try to convince them to allot us with funds. We can turn this around.
I do agree that the developments obtained are substantial. But can your team manage to work even harder for success and reinstate public's faith in ISRO?
Yes, ma'am. It is utterly important that we try again and fulfill everybody's expectation. We will certainly do our
Go ahead with your preparations in full swing. I require monthly status updates.
In the past 60 years, 40% of the space missions have failed. But it's just a part of space exploration. Now that the seniors have approved of our fundings and allotted funds to us, we must not let our earlier failure deter us. We have to work more
Yes, we must do our best.
करिए नस नस मेरी खो दे हाय कुछ करिए कुछ करिए कुछ करिए बस बस बड़ा बो दे अब कुछ करिए ओ कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए जा मरिए हाय कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए जा मरिए
राशन की फलियों में
दिस इज इट Today, with our mission commencing, we will go there where no one has before, the moon's south pole.
Yes, the assembly is complete, rechecking is in order, and we will soon be witnessing our hard work take form.
All reports are clean, no problems have been detected, and we are just a launch away from the sweet smell of success.
But I can't help but feel nervous.
It is quite natural for you to feel so. Just remember all the dedication and willpower it took us to get here, and you will feel much calmer. We are to witness a historical moment.
All instruments and equipments for communication and development are in order. Commence launch. The launch has been initiated by the heaviest rocket built by India. The lander, orbital and rover are tugged and intact.
The Chandrayaan has successfully escaped Earth's gravitation field and entered the first orbit. First orbit maneuver is in order. I repeat, first orbit maneuver is in order.
The launch is a success.
Thank God, we did it.
We are set to receive input.
I hope we succeed.
Landing is in place. I repeat, lander is intact at the destination, and we have begun communicating with the rover from the surface of moon. The orbiter is in place. Chandrayaan 3 is a complete success. We have made our country proud. Congratulations.
It has been such an amazing journey, and we will continue to make such endeavors.
नहीं हाँ मैं हूँ उस देश का बैठ के लिए नजारा स्ट्रैबल और बेस का सीधा चलू या चलू ढाई ढाई चाल मैं खेल मेरा होगा ये देख लंबी रेस का मिट्टी का कर्ज है मैं मर कभी चुकाऊंगा तुझे मिट्टी कर दूंगा या फिर मिट्टी में मिल जाऊंगा जो भी कहा था मैं वो करके दिखाऊंगा इंडिया से हूँ खाली हाथ नहीं जाऊंगा मैं जब के पकड़ झाड़ दूंगा तुझको मैं उखाड़ दूंगा जहाँ से तू आया है ना वहीं तुझे गाड़ दूंगा तेरी जमीन पे आज तुझे ही पछाड़ दूंगा झंडा इंडिया का बटे
वंदे
उड़ान अभी बाकी है अभी तो कई इम्तिहान बाकी है अभी तो नापी है मुट्ठी भर जमी हमने अभी तो नापी है मुट्ठी भर जमी हमने अभी तो पूरा आसमां बाकी है अभी तो पूरा आसमां बाकी है
After the success story, pondering on a serious note, we cannot help but think of the challenging situations, the situations we all are facing at the present. Though we are trying to be brave and trying to find some positive in this situation, as our elders taught us to do, we rejoice in the healing science of nature. Almost zero human activities has done wonders for this otherwise ailing planet of ours.
The water bodies are filled with clean water. The plants and trees are blooming. The birds are chirping. And the creatures are happy with their newfound freedom. But the question arises, with the situation improving and people getting back to routine, will all this vanish?
Now, the students of class 11C, we address this problem in their own way by a PowerPoint presentation titled Don't Squander the Gains.
We, the students of class 11C, are going to present a PowerPoint presentation on the topic Don't Squander the Gains.
India then. India is home to some of the world's most polluted cities. Air quality has been deteriorating across the country since the 1990s. And in 2017, as much as 97% of the country's population was estimated to be exposed to unhealthy levels of ambient PM2.5. In 2017, only one-third of India's cities met the national standard for annual concentrations of PM2.5, which is on average 40 micrograms per cubic meter. The economic lockdown to contain COVID-19 brought unexpected relief from poor air quality. Reports of clear blue skies have emerged from across the country. National Air Quality Index was launched in 2014 with outline one number, one color, one description for the common man to judge the air quality within his vicinity. It has been launched for monitoring the quality of air in major urban centers across the country on a real-time basis and enhancing public awareness for taking mitigative action. Pollution kills. A study shows that pollution kills 8.3 million people annually and air pollution kills 7 million people worldwide annually.
Before the lockdown, the average PM2.5 level all over India was 108.6 micrograms per meter cube, which is very unhealthy. But after lockdown, the data showed 56 micrograms per meter cube, which is a moderate level. Before lockdown, the average NO2 level in the atmosphere was 214.4 into 10 to the power 13 molecules per centimeter square. But after lockdown, it was reduced to 188.4 into 10 to the power 13 molecules per centimeter square.
Five positive changes around us: improvement in air quality index, clean drinking water from Ganga, animals roam freely on streets, birds return to their habitat, the Himalayan range seen clearly after 30 years. Five positive effects of lockdown on us: we are getting sufficient sleep, home care, eating healthy home-cooked food, time to work out, family time.
These pictures taken on March 25 show deserted streets across India. The top row from left to right shows Ghaziabad, New Delhi and Mumbai. The middle row, left to right, is Allahabad, Chennai and Kashmir. The bottom row, left to right, depicts Siliguri, Kolkata and Bangalore.
During the first 3 weeks of March, the average nitrogen dioxide level declined by 40-50% in the cities of Mumbai, Pune and Ahmedabad. The nationwide curfew in India on March 22 also resulted in the lowest one-day traffic pollution levels on record. The reduced fossil fuel emissions due to the transport sector and slowdown in other emissions-related activities is slowly reducing the air pollutants. the top of skyscraper were visible, and some residents told Reuters that they could spot more stars than usual.
Murkier to clearer. Before lockdown, India was home to 14 of the 20 cities with the most hazardous air. After lockdown, sky quite often and enjoy its blueness from the balcony. Investing in a cleaner future. The coronavirus crisis also presents India with an opportunity to invest in a clean energy future. India, a highly fossil fuel country, in order to tackle pollution, we need to tackle that. But when things are under better control, we need to move towards renewable energy faster. With hope in our hearts to surpass the hard times, we shall move to a future of refined lifestyle choices to preserve Mother Nature and hope to be working cumulatively to restore our planet Earth from the destruction that had been caused over the several years. Advent of AI. The different roles played by AI during pandemics are early warning and alerts, prediction and detection of outbreak of diseases, real-time disease monitoring worldwide, analysis and visualization of spreading trends, prediction of infection rate and infection trend, rapid decision making to identify the effective treatments, study and analysis of the pathogens and drug discovery. All these are executed at a greater speed with AI. With modern computer architecture and internet, all these data can be accessed in real time by different institutes to develop an autonomous or collaborative AI model to handle various tasks. In addition to the official data, AI can gather information from news outlets, forums, healthcare reports, travel data, social media posts, and other in multiple languages across the world by using natural language processing techniques and flag their priority.
Digital India. This pandemic has also accelerated technology trends including digital payments, robotics, etc. In this situation, businesses are still staying open due to the technology, and in this manner, technology can help reduce the spread of virus. Due to this pandemic, our society is becoming more technology resilient, and it will be helpful in future also.
Ideas must go on to redefine our nation.
But none of them will happen by itself. We must go on to redefine our nation. Dukkya Sindhu mein gota khor lagata hai. Ja ja kar khali haath lot kar aata hai. Milte nahi sahji moti gehre pani mein. Milte nahi sahji moti gehre pani mein. Badhta dugna utsaah इसी हैरानी में मुट्ठी उसकी खाली हर बार नहीं होती मुट्ठी उसकी खाली हर बार नहीं होती कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती
असफलता एक चुनौती है स्वीकार करो असफलता एक चुनौती है स्वीकार करो क्या कमी रह गई देखो और सुधार करो जब तक ना सफल हो नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम जब तक ना सफल हो नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम संघर्ष का मैदान छोड़ मत भागो तुम कुछ किए बिना ही यूं ही जय जयकार नहीं होती अरे साहब कुछ किए बिना ही यूं ही जय जयकार नहीं होती कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती
The credits of the presentation are as follows. Now, I would like to invite Tipal ma'am to grace us with her words of wisdom.
Dear students, teachers, a huge round of applause to all of you for your performance, for all the efforts, tireless efforts. I can very well imagine how much you have contributed for this type of presentation. It was really a visual treat to the eyes. So, once again, congratulations to all the entire team of 11C. You have shown you have enhanced your IT skills, I think, through this presentation, through this performance. You have enhanced your communicative skills, which you already have, Archisha and Nishtya, I can say about you. So already you are master of this, but other students, of course, they must have done a lot of search work. They must have taken a lot of guidance from the teachers and from the IT trainer teachers, how to go, like how you have imagined yourself in that planet and how you have shown the animations and you have used AI. So it was really very good to the eyes. A sort of movie was there created by you all. And the confidence, the way you have presented the collage, the PPT, so too much informative and proud to be Indian. So, of course, we need to be proud to be Indian, and that is on a broader spectrum. But we need to be proud to be DAVian, and need to be proud of ourselves. Each and every person should be proud of themselves. So if we have this self-confidence, we can always challenge ourselves. Whatever we have done before, we need to challenge that. And then I always say a step further, gradually. And with you, the entire team is always doing this. Accepting the challenges and moving further. Now this is the benchmark for us, so now we have to improve on this. So there is no limit for excellence. There is no limit. This journey has no end. So whatever you have learned today, so as IT professionals, you will be joining maybe some jobs later on after doing your MBA or your engineering colleges. So this all is going to help you a lot, which I think so. So this is a part of learning by doing, project work, ASL project, whatever you can name. So all in one package. So you all are being empowered by your teachers. And of course, we are also empowering ourselves. The teachers are also empowering ourselves. We are also learning from you. You learn more than us in this IT area. And we are also learners. We all are learners. And if we have this type of passion in ourselves, so nobody can stop us. No corona can be there. No negativity can be there. So hats off to you. So happy for you. So happy to be connected to you. Thankful to you all, to the teachers and to the parents also for all the support they are giving us. God bless you, dear children.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now, may I invite Sandeep ma'am to express her views about our presentation.
Thank you, dear. It was, as ma'am has just said, a very, very captivating space journey. I think everybody was glued to the screen seeing the Chandrayaan journey, and it was very well done. Excellent speakers and exhaustive details, I must say, with excellent style of presentations. So well done, 11C. Good job. And Hardik, I know you have been going round with all this technical work.
Great.
Thank you, sir. Good. Very good. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for your words.
May I request honorable judges to express their views on today's presentation? We can start with Mr. Bhalla. Mr. Bhalla.
Hitender, are you there?
Yeah, ma'am, I'm very well there.
Yes, yes.
I think the presentation was extremely well. A lot of work has been done by the students to gather the information, and the presentation style was also good. But I felt that participation and the presentation from multiple students should have been there. That that's the area where other students, as Madam told, should pick up. Otherwise, it was an excellent and a fabulous presentation, and a very good journey and very good depiction of the present scenario. Thank you and all the best to all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your kind words. Now, can we have Mr. Yadav? Mr. Yadav, sir.
Good morning, everybody. Ma'am, the presentation was very good and this is very knowledgeable. And the students are going to learn lots of things in the IT and science, and this will help in near future for the students, and very hard work of the entire team. Congratulations to all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your motivating words. Now, next, can we have Madam Seema, please? Ma'am Seema.
Good morning, all of you, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It was
good morning,
a fantastic ma'am. Program, ma'am. I must say that. Everybody has covered all the points. Still, I will repeat the same. The program was very good. The Chandrayaan movie was literally good, and I was having goosebumps as an Indian. Literally, I must say, the thing which you have covered, the original scenes also, like Mr. Modi was hugging the scientists and the failure and each and everything. I must recommend you can show this movie to the 7th, 8th, 9th class students. You can keep it this, either of the YouTube movies and all. You can keep this in your library, I must say. And secondly, the motivational quotes from Archisha and Nishchay Gupta were an add-ons. They again gave me the goosebumps, though they were an old motivational quotes, but still the way they spoke, hats off to you both of the kids, Archisha and Nishchay. It was very good. I know the hard work of the teacher and it was clearly visible, ma'am. Hats off once again to all of you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Seemaji.
May I now request Mr. Gupta to say a few encouraging words for our students. Mr. Gupta.
Good morning.
He is a parent.
Good morning. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I am Sushil Gupta, parent of Mr. Gupta. Ma'am, I get the hard work of the student and how this presentation. Ma'am, they are doing very well and they are doing hard work, and that can be seen through their presentation. They gather the information from wherever, the internet, or they use their skills, and that they can use in their professional life as well. So it is very useful for them. And I congrats all the students, the teachers, and the school as well. The school provides them the environment for such presentation. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much, and congrats to all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Mrs. Thakur, few motivating words from your side. Mrs. Thakur. Can you hear me, Mrs. Thakur?
Good morning. Good morning, respected principal, ma'am, and teachers. Very good program was there. It was really wonderful. Chandrayaan 3 was really impressive program. And all the teachers and students have put their great effort to this program. Wish for your great success. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am.
So, Hardik, you would like to say something?
Yes, ma'am. We thoroughly enjoyed working on this project.
Share with me your success story, your hard work, how you have done this.
Ma'am, we have worked day and night for doing this animation, transitions, and we learned many things about editing. And ma'am, we also improved our speaking skills.
Yes. Do you think like it was wastage of time?
Ma'am, no. Sometime I think, but after working on this, I really know this. It was a good time for me, in which I learned many things about the computer and editing same.
Very good. Yes, Archisha, and then Chahak, and then Nishchay. Share with me something.
Ma'am, it was a wonderful experience. It was an exhilarating exposure to the world of science, to the world of space for me. I was not aware about the, I was not at all interested in the astronomy till class 10. But now, after seeing this presentation and working on it, it gave me immense pleasure to work on the astronomy. And I think that I'll continue I will continue in the field of astronomy in my future. So yeah, it was a great experience. And ma'am, thank you so much for providing us this platform. And it not only improved my skills, but also under the guidance of ma'am, Rashmi ma'am, Neela ma'am, it also gave me knowledge and kind of motivation to do good further.
It was a great challenge for all of you. I have given you a great challenge, but I want you all to grow. To know this, yes, to learn this, na? So that you will, now you are feeling empowered, and I'm so happy for that.
Yes,
ma'am. It was like studying outside the textbook. It was a great experience to learn and research more about the topic, which I wouldn't have thought of earlier. And it completely changed my outlook about teamwork and cooperation in this new normal that we have to work with day to day.
This is real education. This is real learning, beta. Yes,
ma'am. So even in this these changing times, we all cooperated, we came together. It wasn't like we were learning every day something new. We overcame problems together. It was a great experience. And with teachers supporting and constantly motivating us, it was a very nice journey.
Great, great. Nice to see you, to be connected to you all. Yes, Piyush? Nishchay? Yes.
Good afternoon. Good morning to everyone. Ma'am, it was an immense pleasure for me as we got a intense knowledge about many things like Rafale, and then the positive changes that the lockdown has shown us. We have got an idea to maintain it. So it was nice working with all of them, and I really enjoyed it. Thank you.
Great. Yes, Nishchay?
Ma'am, I would like to say amazing. This project was amazing. I got to learn so many things about Chandrayaan 3, the upcoming project, Rafale, the Bhava Kavach, and moreover the changes, the after and before lockdown. Those were amazing. I got to work with all these wonderful people, the teachers, my fellow classmates. The experience was just wonderful.
Great. I'm so happy for all of you. Yes, Divyansh is here.
Good evening, everyone. Ma'am, I wasn't expecting that the thing which I used to do in my free time will help me in this platform. And even after knowing this, I learned a lot. And with the guidance of our teachers, I think this is success.
Tanya, would you like to say something?
Tanya is there. Tanya, good morning, ma'am. It was a great experience for all of us to be part of Spectrum 2020. We enjoyed and learned a lot during this year. I would like to thank my teachers and school for providing us with this great opportunity. And ma'am, this was an unrivaled experience for all of us. I learned a lot during this project. And ma'am, under the guidance of Neela ma'am and Rashmi ma'am, I learned a lot. Thank you, ma'am. I'm proud to be a Indian and a Bavarian.
I have gone through your result also, all of you. You are doing very well at that level also, all of you. You all are wonderful people. All of you are having a lot of potential. You only need some little bit direction. And we should always be having broad outlook, like learning never stops. From everything we learn, which is going to be whenever we are operational somewhere. So this is going to help us always, always. And God bless you, dear children. So happy to be connected to you, and so happy for all of you. Yes, Neelam and Rashmi, you would like to say something? And so happy for your parents. Yes, Rashmi, ma'am. I know it was a stress, it's a positive stress.
It was a collective effort done by everybody. So we enjoyed it a lot.
Yes, Rashmi.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning to all of you. I am very happy to be part of this, and it was a great journey for all of us. And the most positive aspect was that we could connect with each other. I got to know these children so well, though I was taking their class for months. But this kind of rapport we could never develop.
Absolutely right.
It gave us a chance to understand the children so well. And I would especially like to mention a few children who were working day and night and we were together in this project for such a long time. So they are Hardik, Nishchay, Divyansh, Piyush, Jashan, Anand, Archisha, Chehak, Akshara, Aryan. And we also learned so many things from the children. They have worked so patiently, not even once getting irritated or upset, even though we were making them do things so many times, repeat things so many times, and yet they were doing so well. Thank you very much, ma'am, for giving us this opportunity.
Yes, Neela.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Indeed,
it was not possible.
To my
it was not possible without your motivation, ma'am.
I'm so happy for all of you. Like, we could do it together. And it is better, I think, than what we were doing in the school physically. Because at that time, many parents were not connecting to us. Now your parents, your relatives, they can see you.
Yes.
We are on a broader spectrum. Okay? Yes. God bless you, dear children. All the best.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Nishchay.
Ma'am, now I would like to invite Akshara for a vote of thanks.
Ma'am, we would like to extend our gratitude to Honorable Principal Ma'am for bestowing upon us this wonderful opportunity to showcase our talents. We are extremely thankful to Neela Ma'am for guiding us throughout the preparations, motivating us, to Rashmi Ma'am for supervising us and helping us in penning down our ideas more beautifully and correctly. We need to mention our deepest sense of appreciation to Rohit Sir and Sun Sir for their technical assistance, enabling everyone to do better. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very proactive and dedicated staff of our institution who are well versed in their jobs. Thank you.
Welcome, beta. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, all of you. So now let us express our gratitude to the supreme power, the Almighty, by reciting Shanti Path.
Om Dyau Shanti Antariksham Shanti Prithavi Shanti Rapah Shanti Ro Shadhayah Shanti Vanaspatayah Shantir Vishve Deva Shanti Brahma Shanti Sarvagvam Shanti Shanti Reva Shanti Sama Shanti Redhi Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Once again, congratulations to you all for the wonderful performance.
Thank you so much.
Huge round of applause for your parents also.
Thank
you. Okay, beta. Any other child is left here who is on this platform? Neela?
Aryan Verma, Anant.
Yeah, please.
Aryan Verma has also not spoken. Yes.
Maybe you have done Shanti part, kar liya, koi baat nahi. Let them come forward. Yes.
Aryan.
Yes,
good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Aryan. Yes, you are a silent worker, I know. Yes.
It was a great learning experience, and ma'am, we got to do some very interesting and learning activity in lockdown. And when all of you were saying good views about the presentation, I was thinking that all the efforts were worth it.
Very sweet, Aryan. Yes. Whatever we do, if we do with good intentions, so always positivity comes and always success is there. Yes. And whatever we have done, we can always analyze that and then we can improve on that. If we'll not do anything, then nothing is there.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Anybody else, Neela?
Anant Charan is there. Anant. Is he there or not? Anant.
Jashan.
No. Jashan is also. Akshara ne kuch baat karni hai, wo to formal vote of thanks tha.
Akshara,
you want to say something?
Ma'am, yes, it was a great experience for all of us as we were disconnected from a very long time, but this opportunity brought unity in all of us and we were able to work as a team. And Thanks to you, ma'am, for providing us this opportunity.
Always welcome, beta. Always welcome. We are for you only. Anybody else?
No, ma'am. Neela? I think no, ma'am. Every student has.
So I think now we can leave for today.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much, beta.
So 11C can relax now, right? Bye, everybody.